Although for most of plastics, existing plants are still polluting the air and water and making great profits in Taiwan, I would like to lift up that in 2007, they proposed a new project but couldn't pass the environmental impact assessment. So they decided to go to Vietnam. So that's where we're going to go next. Buckle up because we are heading to our next stop with Miss Nancy Bui. Nancy Bui is a writer and documentary filmmaker. She is also an environmental and human rights activist. Her current role as a Vice President of External Affairs of Justice for Formosa Victims, a nonprofit organization based in Louisiana. JFFV was founded in 2017 to support victims of environmental disasters caused by the Formosa High Tin Company in the central provinces of Vietnam to fight for justice. In 2019, JFFV assisted 7,875 victims in filing a lawsuit against Formosa in Taiwan. The lawsuit is now awaiting the decision of the Taiwan Supreme Court. Vietnam's very own Nancy Bui.
Thank you, Kaylin, for the introduction. Hello, everyone. At the beginning of April 2016, people living along the coast of Vietnam faced an unprecedented horror when they discovered hundreds of tons of dead fish strewn along nearly 250 kilometers of coastline of four provinces. Fear and uncertainty follow as the cause of this phenomenon was unknown. The stench from the dead fish became unbearable, and a diver died after discovering an outflow pipe from the Formosa factory. It was later discovered that the pipe contained many toxic chemicals such as cyanide, chlorine, ammonium, and iron. More alarming, people started getting sick after eating the contaminated fish. When people sought answer from the Vietnamese government, red algae were given as the cause. Eventually, both domestic and international press, especially social networking sites, started to harshly criticize the delay in announcing the cause and pressure the government of Vietnam and Formosa to remedy the situation. In the face of public pressure and mounting evidence pointing directly at Formosa, the manager of the Formosa factory finally released a statement. Do people want fish or steel blend? After 3 long months and dozens of protests, the Vietnamese government finally accepted the result of a study from more than 100 local and international scientists, a study that Reuters news agency called the July Report, which concluded that Formosa was the cause. However, Formosa and Vietnamese government had never published the result of this study and consider it a state security matter. And scientists involved are prohibited from disclosing any details about the July report, which was completed over 5 years ago. On June 30th, 2016, Formosa held a press conference acknowledge its fault and offer $500 million in compensation, but conducted no comprehensive study to determine the real extent of the damage caused. The money was given to the Vietnamese government instead of paying the victim directly, creating the second disaster for the victim and their advocates. In nearly 2018, the Vietnamese government announced it had completed compensation payment. Still, tens of thousands of families had received nothing. And those who received compensation found the sum was not equal to their loss. The victim went to Kien Court to file a lawsuit, but their lawsuit was rejected, citing insufficient evidence. When they tried to appeal, they were beaten and severely injured by the police, arrested, and jailed. Those who spoke out demanding justice for the victim and those who assisted the victim in filing lawsuit were also targeted, arrested, and imprisoned with harsh sentences, including blogger Lê Đình Lượng, who received a 20-year sentence, and Hoàng Đức Bình was condemned for 14 years. More than 20 others are serving long sentences as we speak, while others are still being targeted. The victim was unable to file justice in Vietnam. So they reach out for help from the outside world. The Justice for Formosa Victim Association consisted of Vietnamese living in more than 10 countries around worldwide who have come to help together to help. On June 11, 2019, JFFV helped almost 8,000 victims file lawsuits in Taiwan, where Formosa is headquartered and where most of its shareholders live. The case is now pending at the Supreme Court. The victims in the central provinces who lost their livelihood, which came from thousands of years of traditions, have continued to greatly suffer over 5 years. Most of them have to find whatever work they can find in the southern provinces of Vietnam or neighboring countries such as Laos, Cambodia. They used to be proud sheep and business owner. Now they work for a meager salary while living away from home. Their children often live without both parents, have dropped out of school because their parents can no longer afford it. Those who can pay the broker to work overseas in Taiwan, South Korea, Japan, and Thailand, and live apart from their family. At the end of 2020, Formosa became the largest steelmaker in Southeast Asia, announcing record profits of hundreds of millions of dollars, while victim continues to suffer. The Vietnamese government subsequently announced that Formosa had paid nearly $500 million in taxes. Formosa is a multinational company mainly investing in the production of plastic and chemical. However, they invested in Vietnam to make steel, an area where it had no experience from the first day of its presence in Ha Tinh province. The company caused a lot of damage just to build their plant. With the help of the state, people were forced to relocate without proper compensation. Those who refused relocation had their electricity cut off and their children were unable to go to school. They are living in what is left of their demolished home for the past 10 years. For them, environmental disaster is the third disaster caused by Formosa. I hope the residents of St. James can avoid similar pain. There is no need to build another plastic factory in St. James for a company that had a history of destroying the environment and had caused so much suffering for people who want to live in peace. Thank you very much for listening.